Let's go now. We don't want to keep our friends from the network waiting.
We don't?
No, we don't.
Well, I do. I'm going to keep them waiting.
No, you're going to be a good boy and listen to all the suggestions about who they'd like to see host this new 12:30 talk show that follows us.
Fine. How long do I have to pretend to listen?
Oh, please, Larry, don't piss all over their suggestions.
I am. I'm going to piss all over them.
Try to show a little restraint. And then when they feel as network executives that they've done their jobs, you will tell them who the host is really going to be.
Let me ask you something. Do you think when Johnny Carson picked David Letterman to go after him at 12:30, he went through this shit?
Hell no. Nobody fucked with Johnny.
Exactly.
Before we get started here, I just want to tell you that we're all really looking forward to seeing you at the American Television Awards tomorrow night.
That's just what America needs, another fucking award show.
Political bullshit. Kiss somebody's ass and they send your name to the engravers.
Yeah, I prefer just to do the work and let the work speak for itself, not get caught up.
Yeah, that's right. But Larry, listen, I understand you have a very good shot at it this year.
Really?
Yeah.
Will they send a limo?
Town car.
Oh, good. Much less gaudy.
Could we get down to the business at hand here?
Yeah. Larry, Arthur, the 12:30 slot is wide open.
Mm-hmm.
Now, our only competition so far is Conan O'Brien.
Does anyone know who they're putting on after Letterman?
No, they're keeping that under real tight wraps.
The important thing is who's going on after Mr. Larry Sanders.
We have put together a list of possible host candidates that we're sure you're going to be very, very excited about.
Well, good. Good. I'm all ears.
Well, now, the affiliates have already approved all of these. Okay, first up, Bob Saget.
Hey. Bob Saget, good name. Excellent name. Gee. But he's already doing a couple of shows. Wouldn't this be too much for him?
Bob is a mule.
Well, how about Dave Coulier?
Who?
Dave Coulier. You're just raiding the cast of Full House, huh? You should check into the Olsen twins. I hear once their parents go to sleep, they're wild.
Really? Well, I'll check. See if they're interested.
Okay. Melanie, if I may.
Oh, please. Please do.
Okay, as an executive producer of this show and a talk show host himself, I think I know what it takes to have a successful talk show. I have a couple of ideas.
You have somebody in mind?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Who?
Bobcat Goldthwait. What's wrong?
The affiliates have already rejected that name, Larry.
Is he the guy who makes the animal noises?
Well, I knew you were going to say that right off the bat, but that's just one of his colors. He actually doesn't do that voice all the time. He's a very funny guy.
Yeah, Larry, you know, there's a lot of funny out there. And we're looking for the right kind of funny.
You know, Dennis, I think the kind of funny that, Artie?
Larry feels very strongly about this, and I agree with him. Now, let's all get together and close ranks behind Larry. Let's take a good look at Tomcat.
Bobcat.
Whatever.
The affiliates are never going to go for this.
Well, look, I have a great relationship with the affiliates. Let me sell it to them.
Well, you think Mr. Goldthwait would be willing to do some sort of presentation?
I don't see why not.
I mean, if they don't approve it, Larry, it can't fly. That simple.
Sure. No, I understand that. But Bob is very gung-ho about this. I'm sure he would be happy to.
He's a hungry performer.
Yeah.
That's what we want.
Okay, then. Let's keep a tight lid on this.
Hey, Kevin.
Larry.
Hey, man. Good to see you. Hey, what are you doing here?
Oh, just passing through town, doing my film. Yeah.
Oh. What film? You doing Coneheads?
No. Hans and Franz.
Oh, well, that'll be good, too.
Yeah.
Hans and Franz. Are you Hans or Franz?
Franz. Hans.
Oh,
Franz. No, Franz. Well, Franz. Carvey's Hans.
Franz is a funny one.
Yeah. So, anyway, hey, listen, I heard that you're looking at Saget and Coulier to do the 12:30 slot.
Where'd you hear that?
Carvey.
Carvey should get a fucking hobby.
Let me just tell you, that Hans and Franz thing, that's just a character I do. Normally what I do best is talking to people, interacting, you know? I mean, that's a big part of my act, talking to people. You listen to me? I mean, it's what I do.
Yeah,
you're
like, talking about interacting with people, right?
Right, it's like what we're doing right now. I'm talking, you're, you know...
Look, I'm a big fan. You know, I love you, but the network wants Bobcat Goldthwait.
It's funny, was Gallagher tied up or something?
I think Bobcat will be good.
Okay, you are serious.
Yeah. Hello, listen. Let's get together and talk soon.
Really? About the late night slot?
Hey, Artie. Hey, what the fuck is going on? I thought we were... What is this? Sanders Tamp Saget for 12:30 Gab Comedy Fest? I thought we were keeping a tight lid on this.
Well, we did. They didn't. It's the front page.
I don't need this kind of pressure, Artie.
All right. I'm sure this is the end of it, Larry.
Gilbert Gottfried called, Bob Saget called, Alan Havey called several times, Louis Anderson, Stephen Wright, Robert Klein, and Sinbad.
Damn hyenas, I'll take care of these.
What, was David Brenner out of the country?
Oh, David Brenner sent brownies.
What does the American Television Award look like, you know?
Well, it's probably a statue of a guy with his head halfway up another guy's ass.
I already have a fountain like that.
Yeah.
This is it, gentlemen. This is fucking it. The seeds of disrespect for Hank Kingsley that have been sown so liberally around this office have finally come to bloom.
Does this the left one look longer
Absolutely,
than the right
Vito.
One?
Got it?
Can we...
Okay.
Bring it up about a quarter,
okay, Vito,
please.
Why don't you excuse us for a second. Come back in a second.
Thanks, Vito.
Don't forget to,
thank
to
you,
take
Vito.
Care of you,
yeah, well, sure, when you...
All right.
Look at this. What the hell is that? That horseshit fan club newsletter of yours?
Yes.
How many times do I have to tell you about using office supplies and equipment to put out this goddamn thing?
Please, Arthur, I'm trying to find a local printer who can handle the volume.
Well, what's what you told me 6 months ago?
For the love of God, I cannot talk about this now, Arthur. I just can't.
Hank's thoughts?
Yes. No.
Hank's memories?
Yes.
I remember those winter days when I'd return home from my paper route, my toes and fingers dead from the cold. How I wanted to quit that job, but whenever I mentioned it to Mom, she always said the same thing. Hank, you must always remember, penis, vagina.
Ooh.
Penis, vagina. Penis, vagina. What the hell is this, Hank?
God, it is unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, this is the same thing my mom used to say to me. What are the odds of that?
That's not funny, Larry, because at this very moment, our nation's postal service is carrying over 4,000 of these to homes all over America.
4,000 on our Xerox? Paper doesn't grow on trees, you know, mister.
Why didn't you proof this, Hank?
Well, that is Darlene's job. Isn't that right, Darlene?
I'm sorry, Hank.
I want the person who did this, I want a head on my plate by the end of this business day. Because some scumbag, some useless piece of humanity is responsible for this.
It's awful.
So it wasn't you, Larry?
No, I didn't.
Hank, we've got bigger fish to fry.
Oh, well, excuse me.
Oh, God.
You enjoying your handiwork?
It's kind of a crude way to expand your readership, isn't it, Hank?
Shut your mouth, you little shit.
Hey!
Well, I guess we know which side of the family you get that mouth from.
You listen to me.
You just control yourself, Hank. Okay, Phil. I appreciate a good penis-vagina joke as much as the next man, but,
You think I did this?
It screams you.
It screams penis-vagina more than anything.
Come on, Phil!
I didn't do this. I swear to you, Hank. I admire the idea, but the execution is sophomoric. I mean, if I were going to do something like that, I would have said, like, you come home from a hard day at the paper route, and your mom's standing there, and she has a very thin dressing gown on, and it slips open, and all
that. Easy. He didn't do it. Let it go.
Where's Jerry?
Listen, you just simmer down, and you go handle this with Jerry yourself. I'm talking to affiliates, goddammit.
Larry, I know I don't have to tell you this, but I'm a people person.
Right.
I like people. I like to ask people questions, and I like to have other people watch when I'm doing that.
Look, Stephen, the network is leaning towards Bobcat Goldthwait. I think you'd be great, but there's nothing I can do. My hands are over a barrel on this one.
Goldthwait?
Yes, Bobcat Goldthwait.
Hey, that guy has such a weird energy.
Jerry.
Hey, Hank, how's it going?
How's it going?
Yeah.
How's it going? Well, I read my fan club newsletter this morning, so how do you think it's going?
I don't know. Hey, can you hang out for a second?
Oh, sure. I can hang out long enough to say penis vagina. Penis vagina. Penis vagina. Penis vagina. Penis vagina. Penis vagina. Doesn't sound so clever when it gets thrown right back in your face, does it, Mr. Penis Vagina?
Hank, this is my mom. This is Shirley Capon. This is Hank Kingsley.
How do you do?
How do you do?
What a pleasure it is to meet the mother of this very talented young man. Are you in town to visit Jerry?
No, I'm here with my church group for a Bible study conference.
Okay. I gotta run, because I have some toast in the toasterette. Not the toasterette, the kitchenette. And, pleasure.
So listen, things have been going great for you. You got the TV series coming up with Rickles.
Yeah, yeah.
That is great.
Yeah.
And you're also in the movie Robin Hood Men in Tights.
Yeah, Mel Brooks is
so you must be happy.
Yeah, well, you know, that's not my whole life. I'd like to have a wife, you know, eventually, you know. I'll be like 111 when I have a kid in Little League, you know. I don't know about you, but, like, forget it. But, you know, I kid and I go on a date. I mean, I even, on a blind date, I insist we go to, like, you know, counseling on the way. So, I don't know if it's ever going to happen for me.
Yeah, we'll talk about it later. We'll come right back. Stay tuned. Oh, very funny.
Is that okay?
Yeah, did I get all the plugs in?
Oh, yeah. Was I all right?
Yeah, good. Fine.
Great. So, it's been a while.
Yeah.
It's snowing. Huh?
Give me a break.
Huh?
Come on. Bob Goldthwait's doing the 12:30 show, okay? Look, you're good and everything like that. I think you're really talented, but my hands are tight on this one. He's doing it. His position's filled.
What would you think that I want that slot?
Duh.
Oh, Larry, come on, are you crazy? Are you joking, right? Come on, I got a series. I'm doing movies. And besides, you know, doing the right mind was to do a talk show 5 nights a week.
You.
You really mean?
What are you doing, man?
What am I doing? What are you doing? This 12:30 thing is really. God, it's really making you like a different guy. What's going on with you? I mean, what do I mean? How long do I know you? Like 15 years?
Mm-hmm.
You're changing. You're not even yourself anymore. You know, I ran into Stephen Wright and Kevin Nealon, and I mean, they told me about this, but I didn't want to believe this.
Excuse me.
Hey, Hank. How you been? I haven't seen you in a while.
Awful. Someone's been tampering with Hank's memories.
Wow. Sorry.
Sid, the cue card guy.
Huh?
I caught him off in the parking lot last year during the holiday season. That's my man. But what to do?
Yeah.
You know, these awards tonight. You really think we have a chance of winning?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. You know? Me too.
I would like to accept this very gracious recognition. Thank you very much.
Hey, are you, can I use this?
Larry, how you doing?
Oh, hey, Dave. Hey, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
You
how you doing?
Good. Thanks. I'm going good. Boy, you lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, 80 pounds. I was up around 280. I'm down at about 200 now.
Yeah,
but I feel good. Thank you very
CBS
much.
CBS make you lose that weight?
Yeah. How you been?
Good.
Yeah. Good.
I'm having trouble. A lot of trouble finding one of those guys to take the 12:30 spot after me.
Me too. It's killing me.
Boy, it's fucked. There's only a handful of guys that can do it.
Yeah.
Who are you thinking about?
I can't tell you.
Well, come on.
No, I can't.
Come on,
I'm sorry.
There's no one around. Just
no,
tell me.
No, I know. There's no
who
one around.
Who are you thinking about?
Well, I said I can't tell you.
I'll tell you who we're leaning towards.
I would tell you if
you
I
want
could.
A straw?
I can't. No, thanks. Who are you thinking about, though? It's a big deal.
Well,
it's a big
we're leaning towards Bobcat Goldthwait,
he's great. The animal.
He shouts, and I think that would be good going into a commercial break. We'll be right back.
Yeah, that's cute. I like that.
Who are you thinking about? Come on.
I can't tell you.
Come on. It's between us.
Can't tell you.
Who are you thinking about?
What did I say? Did I say I can't tell you?
If I could, I would. You can't tell me. Yeah. Come on, you should be on a high right now. You're moving. This is going to be great. Who are you thinking about?
Tom Snyder. But don't tell me.
Oh, come on.
Tom Snyder.
Come on.
Tomorrow, Tom Snyder.
No.
Yeah. Tom Snyder.
The original Tom Snyder? His, this guy you...
Yeah. His hair is back.
Wow.
He's ready to go. Tom Snyder.
I'm shocked.
No, it's going to be great.
God.
No, we're very happy with it.
Did Cabot tied up?
I couldn't answer to that.
Well, good luck.
Listen, I'm sorry about that. You didn't win tonight.
Yeah. I'm glad you got that. You
well, I'm happy.
That.
You know I'm happy. It's a nice little pat on the back. But the thing I admire about you, you're the kind of guy, this is not important.
The awards mean nothing.
What's important to
me.
You is the work. And thank goodness for you and your friends and family, you can go out every night and prove yourself all over, and you get that feeling of accomplishment and satisfaction.
Yeah. That's,
and
exactly
that's the best thing.
Feel.
The award is really not that important,
no,
is it?
No. What is that? Is it heavy?
This is one of those rare moments in my life when I know now I can do something for you that I think will mean a great deal.
You want to?
Take the award. I'm not kidding around this time. Take it. Please. It would mean a lot to me to take it. Go ahead.
Okay.
You're insane. Boy, oh boy, are you nuts.
You're
I've
a fucker.
Never seen a guy like you.
You're a fucker. Wow. Good luck with that Snyder thing.
Sure.
Now listen, the affiliates are to my left, all right? Don't look. And I just want you to go out and have... Is there anything I can do?
No, you've already done a lot. I mean, give me this. It's pretty cool. Thanks.
All right, because I think you're going to do great. I just want you to have fun, because just remember, as far as I'm concerned, this is a done deal. All right?
Great.
Okay.
Thanks. Hi, and welcome to the Bobcat Goldthwait Show. That's me, Bobcat, and please watch or I'll come to your house. See, and then, like, the show's not going to be like any other show. I'm not even gonna have real chairs. These are like fake chairs. I'm gonna have beanbag chairs. And I'm not even gonna have a desk. I'm gonna have a beanbag desk, right? So let's say a guest comes on, puts a beverage on the beanbag desk, and gets all wobbly. That'll be funny, right? And then, like, okay, I have, let's say Madonna's on.
Oh, that's great. Artie Hankins, the Kansas City affiliate. Super guy.
Yeah, good.
Well, thank you, Bobcat. I've always been attracted to you. And I'll go, oh, well, thank you very much, Madonna. I've always been a big fan of your work. Oh, no, no problem. You're kind of a, you know, I consider you date bait. But it'd be Madonna. It wouldn't actually be me. And then there'll be a band. I don't know. I don't have the theme written yet, right? But something like that. And then another thing I want to do.
Bob?
Wait, no. Bob? Wednesday is no pants night. I don't care who the guest is. They're not wearing pants.
That's a great one. Hey, listen, Bob. Are you going to do any of this in your real voice or what?
What, are you turning on me, too?
No, no, I'm not turning on you. I just think I can't get enough of this character. You know I love it, but the affiliates, why I think that they want to know that you're something other than just that character. They think that's you. They think it's Guy. They think you're crazy.
But you want me to take it down a little bit?
Could you take it down a little bit? That would be great. Maybe just down to a, you know, 7 or something.
Oh, that is a 7.
That was a 7.
Yeah.
You know, do 2? Would that be asking too much?
No, I can do 2.
Okay, that'd be great.
That's fine.
Oh, it's going. It's hilarious.
Oh, okay.
Just have fun. I'm telling you, this is it's a done deal anyway.
Okay. Sure.
There's also going to be a live band.
Well, we're back from our little interruption. And then, like, another thing on the show, a regular feature is, let's say I have a guest, like Donna Mills, and there's Donna. She's just yammering away, like plugging something. I'm gonna have a big, giant Nerf bat, bigger than this one. And then I just go, oh, that's fascinating, Donna. Oh, please tell me some more about your pets. Boom! Smack her right in the face. I'll hit her right in the face. I wanna hit her so hard, like, you can get some of her makeup right here, a lot of it. It'll be like the holy shroud of Donna. The crowd's gonna go crazy, and,
Is this what you really want? Why don't you go all the way with it and get the young people's favorite, Pauly Shore?
Because I happen to think this is still funny, okay? It's a little different, a little more daring, but if you're not going to do something different, why bother?
The network wants Coulier and Saget. Why not put them together as a team? It worked for the Smothers Brothers.
Because the Smothers Brothers happen to actually be brothers, Artie. I don't believe Coulier and Saget are related.
How about Rowan Martin?
I'm not changing my mind. If I cave in now... The network's going to question me on everything I want to do.
Larry, listen to me carefully. This is not you against the network.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's you against the most powerful people in television, the affiliates, and they're never going to buy it, kiddo.
I have a good relationship with the affiliates. They'll come around.
You see how long that lasts after Bobcat bashes Donna Mills' face in with a Nerf bat.
He's not going to do that. He'll be fine.
He's going to last exactly 3 weeks. And then they're going to dump the both of you and put on reruns of Macmillan and Wife in Hawaii 5-0.
And then sometimes I'm not even going to be on the show. It's just going to be my voice coming from a box such as this one. And it'll just be this disembodied voice. It'll be, you know, like a Beckett play.
How long do I have to make my decision?
You've got to announce it on the show tomorrow night.
I hope we made the right choice.
Well, the networks certainly seem to be intrigued.
Good, good. Well, I feel good about it.
Arthur,
okay.
Look, can I talk to you for a moment, please?
You okay, Sid?
Some asshole put a potato in the tailpipe of my car.
Oh, that's awful. Who would do a thing like
that? I'll kill the bastard.
Settle down.
If I
Sid, what, did you used to work at the post office?
I did it, Artie.
Did what?
I did it. Penis, vagina, penis, vagina.
You put that in the newsletter, Darlene? You're kidding.
I love Hank. I really do. But sometimes he makes me do crummy jobs, and he talks to me like I'm an idiot. I think I just wanted to hurt him.
I know the feeling, you know. We're beginning to worry about you, sweetie, but I think you're finding a place for yourself in this business.
Oh, I hope so, Arnie. Thank you so much.
Secrets. Darlene, put my car up to the back door and have it running as soon as the show is over. And listen, try to keep that interior temp as close to 68 as possible. Capiche?
Yes, sir.
That's my girl.
Miss Vagina.
Bill Clinton has nominated a woman to the Supreme Court, or as Clarence Thomas likes to say, new meat. Now, I would like to get on to a very important issue. There's been a lot of conjecture, a lot of misinformation in the papers about who we are putting on in the 12:30 slot after us, the Larry Sanders Show. And I'd like to put an end to all the speculation right now by announcing and introducing the new host of the 12:30 slot to you now. He's an old friend and a very talented man, Mr. Tom Snyder. Tom Snyder. I would say off the bat, it looks like we've really made the right choice.
Wow, how do I follow this at 12:30? Wow.
Well, it's not going to be easy, Tom, but if there's anybody who can do it, it's you. So, Tom, welcome to the family.
Thank you, Larry. Pleasure to be back on the network, finally out of CNBC and back in, back in the old 12:30 a.m. saddle. It's great.
Well, listen, maybe get a regular chair this time.
Funny man, Larry Sanders. funny man.
Now, listen, what kind of show will you be doing, Tom?
You ask me now.
I ask you now. Be similar to the old show, the show we
love.
Well,
I think it'll be a little one-on-one, you know. That's always been something I've had a good fortune doing, covering issues. I think there's a lot of stuff going on in the world that's important. And, you know, Larry, I think it's high time that late-night television got back to covering things that matter in this world.
Well, I couldn't agree with you more, Tom. And there's eight other people.
No, ten.
Now, what kind of guests will you be having?
Well, I'll tell you something. I'd like to have you on the air. You know, go behind the scenes, get to the bottom of Larry Sanders, and eight other people will do the same.
I'm in.
Great.
I'm absolutely, I'm as good as there, and if I can't make it, Hank will be. No flipping, we'll be right back. Seem to like it, huh?
Yeah, well, they better. It cost us an arm and a leg to steal him away from Letterman.
But it's worth it. We got him.
How did old Bobcat take it?
I thought you told Bobcat.
You were going to tell him.
Well, someone better tell him before this goes on the air tonight.
He's your pal. It's your idea. You
You should tell him.
Fine, I'll tell him right after the show.
Good.
Okay. I feel bad, though.
Oh, come on. We'll let him guest host for a week.
That's a good idea. That's great. That's a good idea, because I like it.
He's a talent. Listen, I have to ask you this again. When Letterman said that he was thinking of Tom Snyder, you sure he wasn't joking?
Yeah, he wasn't joking. Yeah.
Yeah, of course, I asked Tom about it, and he said that he never heard about the Letterman thing.
Really?
Really.
Talk about the pothead calling the kettle black. Dream On is next.